Are you going through a transition in your life right now, whether that's thinking about switching things up in your career or possibly going to get married or having your first child or starting your own business? I get where you're at, and this week's episode is for you. I'm Siobhan Barnes, founder of the Neon Life Society, and I'm going to talk about how to deal with these changes that happen in our lives. You know, when I was working back in corporate, I quit at a time when I was about to be engaged to be married. Back then I was Siobhan O'Brien. I hadn't taken my husband's name. There were no kids in the picture. There was no business to speak of. And all I knew when I left my corporate job was that I really wanted to do something more meaningful with my life and that I wanted to pursue a career on purpose. And for me, starting a business was that vehicle to finding freedom, expressing myself, and doing work that really lit me up and where I could work with people that I really enjoyed working with, both client-wise and colleague-wise. And so, you know, the journey wasn't so smooth. I actually found myself at a bit of a loss. You know, when I left that job, I left behind that identity that I had spent so many years creating. I had, you know, done pretty well in my career and was, you know, very proud of the work that I'd achieved, the deals I'd done, and the quote unquote reputation that I built up in the market. And I really felt like I was leaving that all on the table and walking away. And it was super scary. And that's when I learned my very important lesson that, you know, we are actually more than our job titles. We are more than our CV. It's so true that life is not about all of your achievements and all of your accomplishments. It's really about who you are as a person, how you show up, and how you are on a day-to-day basis that really counts. And you've probably heard this before, but, you know, people talk about, you know, what people would say at your funeral, and people don't really talk about your career so much as the contribution and the type of person that you were and, you know, how you made people feel. So if you're going through a bit of a crisis and perhaps you're not sure about who you are because of some big life change that's going on in your life, I want you to know that that's perfectly okay. You're more than your title. You are more than your maiden name. You are more than your current job role, and you are more than where you are right now in terms of however people identify and associate with you. You are you. At your heart, at your core, you are you, and nobody can take that away from you. And I just want you to know that even if you change your name or you change your title or you change industries or you start a business, at the end of the day, the core of who you are is still real. And I'll tell you, people will fall away from your life who don't understand this new change that you're making or don't agree with it. And as hard as that can be, that's perfectly okay. Because when you are really living a life on purpose and you're being who you really are, your real friends will stick with you. Your real colleagues will stand by you. And the people who are really understanding of you will stick around. And you know what? The people who fall away from your life, as sad as it is and can be sometimes, well, they leave space in your life to welcome in new people who get the real you. And that's when you feel that sense of fulfillment. That's when you feel that sense of purpose. And so I really just want to assure you that you are more than just a title. You are more than just your name. You are you, and nobody can take that away from you in any capacity as you're going through life's transitions. So I wanted to share that with you today and remind you that there is nobody in the world who can do what you do the way you do it. So have the courage to be yourself, go out there, live your message doing what you love, and really build a life that is meaningful and important to you. Because at the end of the day, you're the one who has to be proud of yourself and look yourself in the mirror at the end of the day and be happy with the life that you've created. And you know, you have this ability to create a life that you want. I wholeheartedly believe it. So I would love to hear from you. Are you going through an identity crisis? If so, what's going on for you right now? And what are you scared about? Leave a comment below. In the meantime, I'll catch you next week.